Hey guys, in today's video, we're going to be checking out the brand new NECA Toys Alien Covenant. This is the Alien Creature Pack. So let's go ahead and get some dimensions going for these included figures. The eggs themselves are about 5 inches in height, about four and a half inches for this one. The open one is four, almost closer to five. The Neomorph, the larger version, is 6 inches in length and about 3 inches high. If you want to count the very small Xenomorph or Neomorph, it stands roughly about 2 inches. And also, for those wondering, the face huggers are about 5 inches in length. Hopefully that covers all the basics for the dimensions. This is a fun pack, I have to admit. We'll look at the smallest one first, the smallest thing, and then we'll kind of work our way up. Included in this set is a very, very small, yet highly detailed Neomorph. Neomorph chest burster, I suppose, to be more exact. About the only weird thing about the Neomorph was the way it was, it kind of came out of its victim. It kind of just stood upright, which was very strange. Having, you know, with the other Xenomorph chest bursters, they didn't really come out that way. This one was like a fully realized, fully developed creature, which was very interesting by comparison. It's very small, very lanky, and unfortunately does not stand the greatest just because it doesn't have... Whoops! And try not to drop it in the process. There we go. It's got a very small footing, like I said, and this is all just, you know, rubbery plastic. Some nice detailing, though, I have to admit, for something as small as it is, like even right down to the tail and the texturing there on the tail itself, the spine and the face, really super cool details for a very, very small, very, very small piece. I just kind of wish it could stand a little bit better, but really, it's perfectly fine. Now, one thing I do like, though, is if you picked up the Neomorph, you essentially could get all the, you know, the developing stages of the creature, because in the creature pack, you of course get the small one here. With the Neomorph, you get kind of like the next size up, where now it's kind of moving on its legs sort of thing. Much bigger version of the character as well. Then you get this version. Of course, this is the other one that we're going to be looking at, so it's kind of like, again, the next size up. And then, of course, if you got yourself the main Neomorph, it's right here. So again, some nice way to kind of display the character in the instance that you could have, like, the varying increased growth periods and stages of the creature itself. Here we have the Neomorph in the larger variety, which kind of has more of a... It's almost walking like a T-Rex. Very strong legs and then very kind of... Not as much functional arms from the stand of walking. Of certainly, if it was running, it would be using all fours. But much more lankier hands by comparison and arms comparison to the legs here. Now, it's actually fairly poseable too. Like, the legs hinge outward. You got the forward and back motion. It's got the hinge in the legs. Looks like you can rotate the lower legs too. You can rotate the tail. The tail seems like it wants to pop off a little bit from time to time. Does have a wireframe though, so you can bend the tail too. A little bit extra posing options. Arms, nothing really in the hands. And then your head's got a nice ball joint going on there too. Look, get a load of the mug on this creature. Very bulbous head. Again, sticking to basically when it starts getting to this stage, it gets very bulbous in the head. Again, looks great. Like all the blood and just goo all over it. It looks great. Again, like nice red. It's got like a very wet blood. Like it doesn't look like it's been splotched as much as it's just been caked on the figure. Very much again like how it looks in the movie. It looks just such a cool representation here of the Neomorph. So you get two versions of it. And again, if we just get it to stand, maybe we'll just put it on its four legs. There's the smaller version. I just wish the smaller version could have had some better means to stand properly. It does seem to want to topple over a bit. Then, just kind of move these out of the way. You also get a pair of eggs. Not mirror copies to one another. Obviously, this one's the closed egg. And this one here is the open egg, which really looks great inside. You just see all like the, you can just imagine how mucousy this would be inside the egg here. And I love the competing colors, and yet somehow the colors work very well hand in hand. You've got the lighter pinks making up these little strandlets here of the interior, and then you've got the kind of darker blood red, which really, again, looks quite good. The outside of the egg, it's hard to actually describe it. It looks like it probably was originally black, but they've done it in such a way that they've painted it with brown, and it looks like there's a bit of like this metallic blue going on to it, which looks quite good. And actually, a really nice looking representation of the egg, you know, versus what we eventually then get later on in the series with the actual Xenomorph eggs. So again, like really looking, really digging the early concept designs for the Covenant eggs, again, as a precursor to what we eventually get later on in the Alien movies, where the eggs are slightly a little bit more to the greener and brown tones. I really dig, though, the blue washes, though, on these particular eggs. Now, again, this one does not open. It's just a solid piece of plastic. This one here, on the other hand, can be opened, or is currently opened, and can sport a face hugger. And you get two face huggers, which they don't look like they're all that different from one another. I mean, they appear to be mirror copies to one another, which is perfectly fine. I certainly would be buying tons of these, because then, you know, you can have multiple face huggers, multiple eggs. You can get yourself quite the nice little diorama going on here. The poses look like, or sculpts look like, they are exactly the same to one another. It's a nice interior detailing there. Slight bit of almost like a pink red wash on the interior of the face hugger, and of course your primary, what color would you use for that, like a beige color, or like a very light beigey brown, making use of it. It's a nice darker, slightly darker airbrushing here on the side gills, as well as in the individual little knuckle portions of the legs. As you can imagine, though, these legs are just rubber. They don't actually have any articulation. However, the tail, as you've probably seen with earlier face huggers, you can pose the tail. You can just bend this back and forth depending on how you want to have it displayed. And again, you could have one face hugger slightly peeking its way out from the top of the egg, startling whatever unsuspecting figures standing in front of it. Again, looks quite good. I'd love to see NECA actually entertain the idea of maybe making these eventually adjustable. It'd be obviously a little harder because the wire can only be so thin, but the idea of being able to manipulate the legs possibly around the face of a figure would really be ideal. Or, you know, you could probably get one that is already got the closed-in legs, and then you would just simply slide it over top of an existing figure's head. Either way, great looking set. Again, it's kind of got everything you really would need. Two eggs, two face huggers. Of course, you've got your smaller, I want to say chest burster, but I mean, like, it's a fully realized creature of the Neomorph. And then you've got the larger version of the Neomorph, which is a little bit more poseable. Again, some great solid releases from the folks over at NECA. You should be able to find this relatively easy now in comic book stores, which I found these at, or retail stores as well. A lot of retail stores are stocking these, like Toys R Us and stuff like that as well. But a great looking set. This is kind of like one of those buy several of them, because then you can make a really nice looking diorama, especially when you start bringing in the likes of, for example, the Xenomorph that we just already had a look at, and also the Neomorph, also from the Alien Covenant line. Once again, though, today we're looking at the NECA Toys Alien Covenant. This was the Alien Creature Pack. They've released creature packs before, more specifically to the Alien, the newer Alien, or I guess in sequence of timeline, the Aliens Creature Pack, which had the more Aliens designs of the eggs and Xenomorphs and stuff like that. But this was the Alien Covenant Creature Pack. If you guys like this video, certainly hit it with a like. Always appreciate that. If you also had a chance to subscribe or hit that little bell notification down below, that little tiny icon that's a bell, if you turn that on and hit on your notifications, then you'll always know when future videos are coming up onto this channel. As always, guys, thanks for watching as you always do. Comment down below what you think of this particular set, if this is something that you would pick up for yourself, and I'll see you guys next time.